Very good afternoon, everyone. Professor Adit Gupta, Principal, Meyer College of Education and Director, Meyer Group of Institutions, Dr. Moora Sharma, Head PG Department, and my colleagues as well as my students from MEd, MA and MPhil programs. As we know that why we have gathered on this virtual platform today, yes, we have Mrs. Mohini Tripathi with us, PhD research scholar from Central University of South Bihar with us to deliberate on her PhD topic. And for that, I welcome everyone here and I request Dr. Moora Sharma to present formal welcome address. Dr. Moora Sharma.
Thank you, Dr. Nishtha. First of all, I extend my warm welcome to Professor Adit Gupta, Director and Principal, Meyer College of Education. And then I welcome Mrs. Mohini Tripathi, who is pursuing her PhD from Teacher Education Department, School of Education, Central University of South Bihar, Gaya, under the able guidance of Professor Rekha Kaul. Rekha Agarwal, and prior to this she has done MSc chemistry and MEd and qualified for NET, and she has 2 years of experience in teaching at school level also. As far as our you can say research is concerned, so she has participated and presented papers in near about 24 plus conferences and seminars, and she has published paper in journal books as well as the proceedings. And lastly, as far as her interests are concerned, I think she has mentioned about her interest in chemistry, that is spectroscopy, etc., and research methodology, curriculum development, education technology, etc. So I welcome you, Mrs. Mohini Tripathi, for this research colloquium. And next, I welcome my faculty members who are there from PG Department of Education. And then lastly, the students from MA first semester, as well as fourth semester, MEd first semester and fourth semester, and MPhil second semester students to this research colloquium. So, this was all from the welcome. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Moora Sharma, sir. And now I request Mrs. Mohini Tripathi to start her presentation.
Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, you are audible. You start sharing your PPT.
Okay. First of all, thank you for inviting me to such a great platform where all researchers try to understand what is the research and how they can perform their research. And I would also like to thank the people of this college and faculty and members. Thank you so much for inviting me and giving me the opportunity to present my work and my experience in my. Yes, thank you. And without wasting my time, I'm going to share my PPT over here. So technical issues are there.
You are not able to share your PPT?
Some technical issues are there. Let me rejoin the platform. Thank you.
Does she have a sharing permission, ma'am?
Is it visible?
Not as yet.
Okay, please visible.
No, no, I don't think so it is visible.
But okay, ma'am.
Or maybe Naveen ji was, I think so, sharing earlier.
Yes. Naveen, I have shared this PPT with you also. Can you share, Naveen?
He had, I think so, left the meeting in between or something.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Okay. I'm sharing the screen.
Okay.
I'm wait.
Yeah, it is visible now. So Mohini ji can see that presentation.
Yes, thank you, Naveen. Mohini, are you recording your screen? Go.
Her audio is also not very clear.
Yes. Probably she is having poor internet connectivity. Hello.
I think so. Can she rejoin? And disconnect and rejoin, maybe.
Yes. Mohini, ma'am.
Well, I think so. I have to call her, ma'am. She has left the meeting and she can rejoin now, maybe.
Okay, not is visible. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Okay. So, my today's presentation is on effect of STEAM through group work learning approach on academic achievement in science, creative thinking skills, and collaborative skills at elementary level. First of all, it is a need of a time to know what is STEAM education and why it is required in day-to-day's our life. So Indian education needs paradigm shift in every aspect, such as pedagogy, curriculum, class environment, student-teacher interface, single disciplinary pattern, etc. And it can be achieved by creating the younger generation with effective and efficient education methodologies, which prioritize the conceptual understanding instead of rote learning. Education should also be able to for the character building and inculcating the values which make the learners to be ethical, rational, respect others, as well as cooperative and responsible. So therefore, the need of the today's life is to give the education that is holistic and multidisciplinary education. In this pattern, the NCF also says that the purpose of the science teaching ought to be to promote the normal interest, spirit of inquiry, and inventiveness of the learners in the field of science. Therefore, it is a need of time to make the learners to be creative innovators and also the problem solvers so that they can be self-reliant. And also needs to flourish the life skills like cooperation, communication, and creativity, and to be a self-reliant. Therefore, our NEP 2020 also says that we need to evolve pedagogy that design education to be creative, enjoyable, experiential, holistic, integrated, inquiry-driven, discovery-oriented, learner-centered, and flexible, as well as multidisciplinary approach. Recently, the multidisciplinary approach in the form of STEAM has aroused interest at the global level. Then the question arises, what is STEAM? STEAM is nothing but the integration of science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics to give the delivery or to make the learners get their own knowledge. Therefore, hello. Yes, so it is a need of time so that we cannot bound in a single disciplinary approach. We need to give any topic or any point of the any topic of the subject so as to give them in integrated manner in the form of arts, engineering, mathematics, science, and education. So therefore, what is the effect of a STEAM approach of learning? So that it will be make our learners to be the problem solvers. How? We give any problem of our day-to-day life. For example, we give the environmental education. If we want to teach them, then we give global warming. So what are the problem related to global warming? We will give one problem and some contents related to that. So they will, what they will do, they will read it, they will observe their environment, and they will observe their surroundings. Then they will try to point out the what is the problem and how it can be solved. So they become the problem solver. Another way is to give the topic and they will construct their own knowledge. So they are bound to be innovators, as they are bound to think innovatively to solve any problem, to construct their problem, to construct their knowledge about any topic. Also, we give the this problem solving or any topic to construct their knowledge in a group, so that they can be collaborators. They will help each other. They will take help of each other. They will respect each other's ideas, and so they will become the collaborators. And also, this is also the skills of teamwork. So they will always have the skills of teamwork. And last but not the least, they will be the thinkers. They will be creative thinkers. They will think critically. They will be reflective thinkers. So another thing is that, what is STEAM? First of all, the background we have to know how STEAM evolves. During the 90s, the USA performance in the PISA was very low. To enhance their performance, they focused on the science and mathematics subjects. Then we know that engineering and engineering and technologies are not separable from the science and mathematics. So they form a four subject integrated term, STEM. Science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Then, because the lack of arts, they were not interested in that field, and therefore the lack of interest of the students, they added the arts features in that STEM, so it becomes the STEAM. So STEAM can be explained as the inclusion of arts and humanities in the STEM education so as to make them innovators and creative. Therefore, the arts features are subjective, intuitions based, unique, and based on feelings. While the STEM disciplines are objective, logical, and analytical in nature, therefore, arts and science are incomparable and indispensable parts of education, but are also complementary to each other. Therefore, we can see that the core skills of arts are also important scientific tools because they are inquiry-based imagination, which focus on questioning and understanding the concept as well as finding the answers of to a given problem through their creative and innovative ideas. Therefore, STEAM approach of learning prepares the student to solve the problems and different issues through creative and critical thinking skills, cooperative and effective communication. Next slide, please. And in my research, there is also one term, group work learning approach. What is group work learning approach? Group work is nothing but the students working together in a small group enough that everyone can participate in a collective task that has been clearly assigned. So this reflects the varieties of instructional practices which encourages a student to work together to get an answer of a question or a solution of a problem or for the productivity. So they co-construct the concept with their peers or group members. And many results shows that the learning outcomes of this approach is very high. Such environments thrives collaborative skills like interpersonal relationship, learning to look into others' perspective, positive attitude towards peers. They also became the patience towards listening to others' ideas and views, and they have high self-esteem, etc. Therefore, in my research areas, we can see many question arises. Next slide, please. Many research question arises like, does the STEAM through group work learning approach influence academic achievement in science at elementary level? Does the STEAM through group work learning approach influence creative thinking skills at elementary level? Does the STEAM through group work learning approach influence collaborative skills at elementary level? Therefore, the problem can be stated as effect of a STEAM through group work learning approach on effective academic achievement in science, creative thinking skills and collaborative skills at elementary level. Next slide, please. To answer these research questions, I have formed the objectives of the research. There are basically three main objectives that need to be answered, such as that is first to study the effect of a STEAM to group work learning approach on academic achievement in science at elementary level, to study the effect of a STEAM through group work learning approach on creative thinking skills at elementary level, to study the effect of a STEAM through group work learning approach on collaborative skills at elementary level. And to achieve these main objectives, there are some two subsidiary objectives, like first to prepare an intervention program based on a STEAM through group work learning approach for class 7th in science, because My main independent variable is the STEAM through group work learning approach. So for this, I have to prepare intervention program to provide the students for class 7th, as my sample is class 7th in science, as well as to prepare the measuring tools for academic achievement in science, creative thinking skills and collaborative skills for class 7th students. Therefore, on the basis of objective, research hypothesis is formed. The first research hypothesis of this proposed research is there will be a significant difference in academic achievement in science at the of the learners taught by STEAM through group learning approach and traditional approach. The second hypothesis based on second objective is there will be effect of a STEAM through group learning approach on creative thinking skills of learner. And the third one is there will be effect of a STEAM to group learning approach on collaborative skills of learners. These are the research hypotheses, but while performing the research or doing the research, this cannot be tested. So for testing the hypothesis, we have to form the null hypothesis on the basis of these research hypotheses. So the first null hypothesis based on the first research hypothesis will be, there is no significant difference in the academic achievement of science of the learners taught by STEAM to group or learning approach and traditional approach. On the basis of second research hypothesis, the null hypothesis will be there is no effect of STEAM through group or learning approach on creative thinking skills of learners. And the third will be there is no effect of STEAM through group or learning approach on collaborative skills of the learners. So basically, we have to test these three null hypotheses in order to find the what is the result of my studies or what will be the findings of this study. These are based on the review of literature that I have done. So I have to give the rationale of this study, why I am choosing this topic and how I came to this problem, to solve this problem. So first I'm going to talk about STEAM contribution to boosting creativity, broaden perspective. These results came from many research like by the Constantino, Kellum, Karamot and Crowder in 2010 and Ghanbari in 2015, Kim and Park done their research in 2012. So these were the findings of these three researchers in which they found that STEAM contribution to boosting creativity and broaden their perspectives. And the another research done by Leong in 2017 found that art education can play a leading role in shaping new pedagogical experiences. That is the mainly required in this era of the education. Next, the Bertrand in 2019 found that sharing the learning in the STEAM program with the community extends their learning experience. So sharing is the main component of this program that he found in this in his work. Another Hoffman and Mercer in 2016, Irina in 2019, Paul Mercer and Ballman in 2019 also found that the group work is most productive for learning and the development of interpersonal relationship. That is their teamwork skills, also the collaborative skills of the learners. And Guyotti et al. In 2015 found in his research that collaborative actions and interdisciplinary as vital aspects of the creative and achievement when the collaborative approach of STEAM by group work was implemented. So group work is also the main important factor to enhance their collaborative skills and the teamwork skills. This because in my PPT there are many ways of reviewing the literature. One should take care of that main problem is that when we write the synopsis or when we write the thesis, many researchers that we have reviewed during the review literature is missed out. So how can we take care of this problem? So I was trying to show how we can miss out, how we can take care of this problem. But due to I'm not sharing the PPT, I cannot show you, but I can tell you that in the Excel sheet, when we in each column, we point out the name of the researcher, time in which their research have been done, the title of the research, APA citation heading we have to give, and what are the research questions of that researches, and also what are the findings and what are the samples and procedure that it is qualitative research or it is quantitative research, the population sizes that and how they are using experimental researches there or survey researches there. We can mention out every researches while reviewing the literature. So I have prepared one Excel sheet in which every research is what I have read and found that it is suitable for my research. I point out what is the researcher's name, in which year they have done, what is the topic of their research, APA citation, so that we cannot miss out that point, if you have to write an APA citation to 7th edition, or you may write it in MLS style, or you may write in Chicago style, whatever the format you have to use according to your university or college references they provide. So we can, with this effect, we can list out the all the resources that we have read and point out all the problems and the solutions and the research questions, the method of the study, and etc., like quantitative or qualitative. So it will be easier for us while writing the report or while writing the synopsis of our study. It is a very effective method. I have applied this in my research. So I can able to say that I'm not left out any of my research that I have reviewed. Okay. So the next is operational definition of the variables that I have used in my title. The first one is steam throughput learning approach. Steam throughput learning approach is basically the combination of two learning approaches, that is steam learning approach and group learning approach, applied in teaching learning process. Steam learning approach is basically an advanced version of STEM education and can be known as integration of arts in STEM, science teaching, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics disciplines. It is modern multidisciplinary approach to teaching learning process. Through this approach, any concept or a topic can be taught involving different streams, provided hands-on experience. While the group learning approach involves a team learning process where members with different capabilities work together, supports and rely on each other to achieve a set of educational objectives. Thus, a stream through group learning approach may be defined as learning approach which involves multidisciplinary approach of a STEAM learning approach and team learning approach of group learning approach. Another one is academic achievement in science. What is the academic achievement in science? In my research, it may be defined as the amount of subjective content of science a student learns or grasps in a determined amount of time. Each grade level has their own objectives and goals, instructional standards. It refers to the extent to which these goals and objectives are achieved. Creative thinking skills. In my research, is the capability of individuals required in the production, evaluation, and improvement of ideas which results in original, unique, and efficient solution, advances in knowledge, and impactful expressions of the imagination. While the collaborative skills is in my research is a way in which students are expected to behave for the development of themselves, society, and nation. In my research, it can be explained as sharing, respecting others' ideas, communication, listening to other, caring, cooperative, responsibility, etc. Therefore, the methodology of this study, basically my research, this problem is quantitative in nature. And for this non-equivalent group control group design of quasi-experimental design was used. As you can see in this table, there are two groups, control group and experimental group. The control groups, first we will take the pretest of both the groups, then we will apply the teaching learning approaches. Like to control group, we will give traditional approach of learning, and then to the experimental group, we will apply the intervention, that is steam through group or learning approach, and then we will take the posters of both the groups, and we will analyze the data on the basis of this pretest and posters. To enrich the research, some qualitative data was also collected to have more complete understanding of research problem or question. That is, I have taken the feedbacks of the students, like how they experienced while the intervention was given to them, what did they learn during this procedure, and were they happy, or were they, what were their feelings when we apply this approach of learning? So these were the feedbacks taken from the students. Also, I have taken the interviews of their teachers to know what were their performance in their exams. Therefore, the population of my studies was the elementary students at their district, because my university is in Gaya. So for the convenience, I have taken the students of the Gaya districts. And my sample was schools with two sections were chosen conveniently, so as to take one section as experimental group and one as control group randomly. Thus, the students of class 7th of Government Middle School, Dela, was taken conveniently. The tools are also very important, and to make the tools, they are very difficult and very long procedure to make the tools. Therefore, I have taken two standardized tools already prepared. That one is the creative thinking skill was measured by verbal and non-verbal test of creative thinking by Bakar Mehndi. This test involves the originality, fluency, and flexibility dimension for the verbal test, and originality and elaboration dimension for the non-verbal test. And the second test that I have taken, standardized tool, that is collaborative skills of the learners, that was measured by the tool named as CoMeasure, which was developed by Hiro Kingsley, Andrew, and De La Cruz in 2017. This tool is basically based on the measure the collaborative skills of the learners while performing the STEAM activities. Therefore, this CoMeasures has two goals aimed at assisting researchers and teachers to identify the collaborative skills specific to STEAM activities and to assess student collaboration during STEAM learning at individual level. The original dimension consists of, first, the peer interaction, how they interact during this activities. So there are three. I was also going to show you these tools, but because I'm not sharing the PPT, therefore I cannot able to show you this tools. And the second dimension is positive communication, how they communicate with them. So there were three measures, like poor communication, average, and one is the effective communication. So we have to tick mark while observing the students, how they communicate, the inquiry based, and other dimensions also. And the last one, that to measure the academic achievement in science, that tool I have to test, I have to prepare by myself. Therefore, it will, before applying this test, I have gone through its validation and reliability. I've also checked that. And also I have prepared questionnaire and open and closed ended question for the students and teachers, and semi-structured interview for the teachers and principal of that school. Next slide, please. So the data collection and data analysis data was collected by pre-test and post-test and questionnaire with open-end, closed-ended questions. The quantitative data was obtained from these. The qualitative data was obtained from observation schedules and semi-structured interviews. Quantitative data was analyzed through ANCOVA, because I have not done the randomization of the students while taking the class. So I have to apply the ANCOVA. While the qualitative data was analyzed through content analysis of that schedules and interviews. So, and the findings, what were the findings of my study? Because I still have to submit for the pre-submission, still I'm doing the analysis of the data, but I can tell you what were the findings of my studies. The first, according to the null hypothesis, first, when I have done the testing of the null hypothesis first, I found that there is a significant difference between mean scores of academic achievement in science of the learners learned by traditional method and learners learned by the stream through learning approach. The total number of students were taken 40, so N was 40. The mean score of traditional method was 45, and the mean score of the test of the stream learning approach was 17. And while counting the SD, I came to know that the SD of the traditional approach was 4 and the stream learning approach was 10, and SD of the total was 1.8. So the calculated T value was 8, which is much higher than the table value, that is 1.99, at 0.5 level of significance. Therefore, I can say that there is significant difference between the mean score of academic achievement in science of learners learned by traditional method and learners learned by STEAM learning approach. Therefore, my null hypothesis first was rejected. Thus, you can see in the figure the findings of this study. The red one, orange one, is traditional approach, because N is the same number of students, so it is same level. And while the mean, you can see the differences, and SD also you can see the differences. So the next second hypothesis finding was also the same, that there is significant difference between the mean scores of creative thinking skills of learners learned by traditional method and learners learned by stream learning approach. Because my this null hypothesis was also rejected. Why? Because the T calculated value was 11.5, and which is much more higher than the table value 1.99 at the 0.5 level of significance. So you can see in the graph the same way that it was from the first hypothesis. So the next third hypothesis, which was also have the same result, that is there is significant difference between mean score of collaborative skills of learners learned by traditional method and learners learned by stream learning approach, because this hypothesis was also rejected, as the T calculated value of this hypothesis was 13, which is much higher than the T table values, that is 1.99. at 0.5 level of significance. So it can be also be shown in the graph. In the same way, we can see that the mean score is, there is much differences, and also the SD also have much differences in the both the approach of learning. These was the findings of my studies. So, and it is also very important to delimit our studies, because we cannot do the research work in a broader area, and we have to be pinpointed so that we can complete our study at the limited number of time or limited number of days, whatever we have. And so my study was delimited to class 7th students of Government Middle School, Delhi. I was also delimited my study only to Bihar Board, was taken for module development, and also the STEAM and group or learning approach was in the field of chemistry only, because my stream is chemistry, so I have chosen the field of chemistry only for making the module for class 7th Bihar Board students. Therefore, this was the references in APA 7th edition style. And thank you. This was all from my side. If you have any queries, please, you can ask. And please stop the presenting so that I can present myself, my PPT. Tools.
Thank you, Mohini. Now I request Professor Adit Gupta, Principal, Meyer College of Education and Director, Model Institute of Education Research Group of Institutions, to delivering the presidential remarks, sir.
Right, thank you, Dr. Nishtha, and thank you so much, Mrs. Mohini for presenting her work and sharing her results with us. I'm sure that the faculty of the Meyer College of Education and students of the PG Department of Education could get some key pointers about making the presentation, especially the research findings and the presentation in terms of how to report the hypothesis, etc. So good work has been done in this area, and I must commend the scholar for taking up this area of study, which is very prevalent area today, because STEM education, or as we know now, STEAM education, is become the new buzzword in teacher education, and everybody is trying to conduct research in this area, and the way the data has been presented, it shows that a lot of work is being done in India as well, and not just abroad. So I would like to first of all comment and say that I'm happy to see that a study has been done using both quantitative and qualitative analysis of data, because mixed method research is the new way to go, and just quantitative analysis of data is not enough. It needs to be corroborated with qualitative data, and that has been done through student interviews. I don't think so that student interviews were presented in this presentation, but
yes,
it would have been good to see how the questionnaires and how the tools, the quantitative data from the tools could have been validated, or the construct validity of the data could be established by deriving some kind of a relationship with the qualitative data in terms of interviews. That would have been interesting to see. I'm sure once your thesis is fully done,
yes,
we would be able to see that part as well.
Yes, sure, sir.
And with regards to there was just one observation that I had. You have taken students from class 7th, but you were always trying to say that the data has been or the study has been done at the elementary level. So the elementary level would be probably till only class 5 or 6. Class 7 we usually take as the middle level.
8th then. At elementary is till the 8th level.
What, till the 8th level?
Okay. Yes, yes.
But we usually take it as a middle level, 7th and 8th classes.
Okay.
Because 9th and 10th become secondary, so I don't think so. Mm-hmm. From elementary to secondary, it's a jump. I think
the primary is still the class 5th is the primary level, and from 6th to 8th, it is
elementary.
Elementary, or you can say the middle school.
Right. Mm-hmm. So good work has been done. Presentations and adequate statistics have been used. I could suggest. You could use, there is a statistic called Cohen's D, which could be used to substantiate your results of the t-test. This is basically effect sizes, so it determines whether there was a small effect or a large effect between the two variables, and if your t is significant, so that will just help you in further corroborating your results.
Okay. And, thank you so much.
Also, it is advisable, like for example in table 1, your t data should be in two decimal figures rather than just a single number 8. Mm-hmm. So it could be 8.0.
Okay.
And then
thank
I would appreciate if you could write down at what level that was significant. So t at 8 is quite high, then even at 0.01 level. So,
yes, yes. Basically, I have decided when I've submitted this synopsis of my study that I have chosen the 0.5 level of the significance.
Okay. Right.
So I have to write that, I have to mention that in my thesis also.
Right. But since it is significant at 0.01 also, under the table, you could always write it is significant at 0.01 also.
Okay. Thank you. For your valuable suggestions, I will definitely take it in under consideration.
Right, and probably you didn't share the results of the ANCOVA, which you have used.
Actually, I'm still processing it.
Right.
The content analysis also I have not done, so not to present that option.
Okay. So how much time do you think is it going to take for you to complete this?
Minimum 6 months I have to, because in between I have to take, I have to give some exams also, so I have taken 6 months time for my pre-submission.
Okay, great. No, but good work done, good area chosen. Yes, it would be, you know, very, I'll be happy to see if you could, you know, bring out how STEAM education.
I forgot to. I have to show that my lesson plans also.
Because
I'm not able to share my screen.
That's okay.
Things I have not shown. For example, I have to teach the states of matter.
Right.
So, states of matter, I have given them stones, water, and plastic bags and balloons and the thermocol plates and glasses, so right. that they can see the shapes of the solid, liquid and gases, what fixed or not fixed, the volume, how they changes the volume, and also the mass and things. So individually or in group, they perform these activities. Then the structure of this atom at the different states of matter, they perform an activity that they draw a square, and students are standing on that square in different manners. Like in gases, only 4 or 5 students will be there. In liquid, some more students will be there. And in solid, the compact, there will be no space in between the students. So they will see that activities, and also they will write the what they have seen and observed during this activities. Then they are set, they are asked to draw their own that modules or models, etc. One group made the that is clock for changing of the states, like different temperature, solid changes into liquid, then what is called that state, that is this type of clock they have prepared. So while making this clock, they use arts, mathematics, science, as well as technology and engineering. Therefore, so this whole activity is based on this STEAM. Therefore, we try to take the integrate all the subjects like science, technology, mathematics, engineering, and technology. It is not said that in all the activities we have to apply all the 5 streams, but at least 2, 3, 4 streams we have to apply. So these are the activities that I have used in my lesson plans. In this, I have developed the modules.
Right. Because one of the questions I'm sure it's going to be when you present your final thesis is why STEAM? Why not STEM?
Yes.
And where is the art component in your, you know, lesson planning or in your approach towards teaching? So you've covered science, technology, engineering and mathematics, but where is the art component?
So they try to perform the activities while role playing, and they also write the slogans and poems according to that. They draw out the structures, and they also construct the module or model in which they apply the arts factor.
Right. So this is one area where you need to, you know, prepare well and be prepared for those kind of questions.
These questions I've already sought out in my synopsis. I'm not able to understand what is this team.
Right.
This is very challenging.
We are happy that you are doing this and you are working on a right stream. I wish you all the best and hope we receive good news about your results soon.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. I thank Dr. Adit Gupta for wonderful remarks on the colloquium. Now I request Dr. Bharti Tandon if students and faculty they have any questions.
Thank you, ma'am. We have a few questions. I try to group them and have the same questions put together. The first question we have is, did you face any difficulty collecting data, and was the data collected in the COVID 19 period? So any difficulty that you faced collecting data?
Actually, I have collected the data before the 90% data was collected before the lockdown period. So I didn't face any difficulties in collecting the data, because students were eager to know what we have to do in tomorrow, what we'll do, we are perform activities in tomorrow class. Ma'am, they always ask these questions. And but the challenging question is to develop the module. It is very challenging to make the activities which is based on all these five elements, in integration of these elements. So because students are very eager to learn by themselves, and also when they perform the activities, they are also very happy to perform, and they're also very creative. We teachers, we bound them to learn this traditional approach, but they are very creative. For example, I've asked a question, if your water bottle there is one hole in that bottle, what you will do to prevent the water leakage? They said, ma'am, we will usko main aag se jala ke usko band kar dunga chhed. एक ने बोला, मैम एमसीबी जो लगाते हैं एमसील वाला, वो लगा देंगे. कोई कहता है मैम सेलो टेप चिपका देंगे, कोई कहता है मैम वहां पे प्लास्टिक लगा देंगे. तो डिफरेंट आइडियाज, ईच एंड एवरी स्टूडेंट्स गिव द डिफरेंट आइडियाज, सो दे आर वेरी क्रिएटिव, एंड वी नीड टू एनहांस देयर क्रिएटिविटी.
Definitely. And yes, it was very interesting to know that they all were so engaged in giving you different answers for that. So there's another question. Is there a specific reason you chose elementary stage, like seventh class?
Yes, because I have chosen this stage because I've gone to that school. The class six students were not present there. Basically, I was trying to take class six or seventh student, because class six students were not present. The whole class was not there. Therefore, I chosen the class seventh, and because age is very innovators, we can say these age of the children are very innovators, and also they work together. Although they have many differences out of the class, but while performing the activities, they are very cooperative, and they forgot all the differences what they have and perform the activities together and collaboratively. So I've chosen that classes for my study. While doing the pilot studies, I've chosen that class.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. There's another question. Could you share some of the implications of your study?
Implication? Yes, of course. The first implication is that which our NEP 2020 is also saying that we have to make our students self-reliant, so that there is no issue in the employment or another. And also, we need the students to be creative, so that whatever the challenges they face in their life or day-to-day life, they can solve that problems through their innovations. And also many innovative solutions also came during my teaching that classes. So I can say that the students can be self-reliant, and also they will be innovators and creators if we approach this learning. So this is the main implication of my study. It is done very, I can say that in at global level, it is doing very vastly and also very good. But in our India, it is still to be explored. But I can see that the government of Madhya Pradesh is very active in this field. In 2019, they started in this area. And recently, they have done that international conference on this team at the school level. So we can say that although in NEP 2020, they have not talked about a stream, they have talked about STEM. But we can apply this art factor. It is very important, because our day-to-day life cannot be, we cannot say that art is not in there in our life. In every aspect, we see arts in our life. So it is very important to integrate this art in our day-to-day life and in our education system also. And this this due to this factor, our teaching also become very interesting and enjoyable. So it is very important, this aspect of area. So these are the main two implications of my studies.
Alright, thank you, ma'am, for sharing the arts perspective to STEM mm-hmm. and the implications of your study. I think these were the questions that the students were eager to, you know, get your answers mm-hmm. on. Next, ma'am.
Good.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much, Professor Adit Gupta, Principal, Mayur College of Education, Dr. Moora Sharma, Head PG Department, Mayur College of Education, staff and students. I deem it my proud privilege to propose formal vote of thanks on behalf of Center for Educational Research, MAER, to this August gathering here. I take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to our young and dynamic principal, Dr. Adit Gupta, who is working day and night tirelessly for promoting research culture in our college. I am thankful to Mrs. Mohini Tripathi, PhD Research Scholar, School of Education, Central University of South Bihar, Gaya, for delivering the colloquium on the topic Effect of STEAM through Group Work Learning Approach on Achievement in Science, Creative Thinking Skills, and Collaborative Skills at the elementary level. I'm sure our students and staff have been immensely benefited by your scholarly presentation on the said topic. I'm indeed grateful to you, ma'am, for sparing time from your valuable schedule. Thank you.
Thank you.
I would like to extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Moora Sharma, Head PG Department, Mayur College of Education, for presenting formal vote of thanks and providing moral support in organizing this event. I would like to express my deep felt thanks to my colleagues, Dr. Bharti Tandon, Dr. Bindu Dua, and Mrs. Ruchika, for their unconditional support and executing their duties in time. I am gratefully thankful to Mr. Naveen for providing technical assistance before this colloquium and during this colloquium. Thank you, Mr. Naveen. I am indeed thankful to all the first and fourth semester students from PG department as well as MPhil students for being patient listeners and making the colloquium interactive. Thanks, one and all. Now everyone can leave this meeting. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everybody, for organizing.